I'm very happy to introduce you some exciting new technologies, particularly in the field of wearable electronics. I'm going to tell you a bit more about something I'm working on, the sensory glove. Sensors embedded into a glove can make an incredible number of things possible. The sensors are used to measure all the movements made by the fingers and also by the whole hand. By this, I mean the flexion, extension of each finger, the rotation of the wrist, and the position of the hand in the space around it. Okay, but what is this for? You can throw away your keyboard and mouse. Using the sensory glove, the interaction with your computer would simply go like this. Move your hand for shifting your cursor, flex your index finger for left clicking, flex both fingers for dragging and dropping, flex your medium finger for right clicking, open thumb and little fingers for switching among different applications, and finally, opening a virtual keyboard and essentially completing your texts by writing in the air. I know that many of you are also now wondering, and what about gaming? Of course! With the sensory glove, gaming can be even more immersive than it currently can be on traditional consoles by being able to change your viewpoint, open fire or change your gun just by using the movements of your hand. And what about the idea of being able to control your drone? With our sensory glove, to control the drone, you'd need to simply and intuitively move only one hand. Apart from gaming, the computer can be used for undertaking CAD drawings, that is, a 2D or 3D picture of assembled components. CAD software is very complicated to use, and to finalize complex designs is by no means a trivial task, meaning that CAD software is not for everyone. But the sensory glove opens a new era of possibilities. You don't have to learn how to use the CAD software. It is the software that learns your commands. For example, by simply touching a ball to make it fall from the table, or closing your fingers to virtually grab and lift a cube. This is all recorded by the sensory glove and transferred directly into the CAD software. While it's not represented in the video, you can also take a virtual object, manipulate, strain, twist it, and give it any shape you desire. When you are satisfied with your creation, you can feed a 3D printer to have the physical version in your hands within a matter of seconds. By now, I hope you are being able to realize that with the sensory glove, you will have the ability to interact with a computer in every way you want. You will essentially be equipped with a virtual bionic hand. Keep a date with me to follow the development of exciting new technologies worldwide, especially wearables.